Hello friends, welcome to Civil Engineers Club. Today's topic is burned brick masonry work. We will see the burned brick masonry. Masonry is used to indicate the art of building structure in either stones or bricks. The masonry wall is built individual blocks, materials, stones, bricks, concrete, hollow blocks, cellular concrete and laterite, usually in horizontal courses cemented together with some form of mortar. We will discuss here about the brick masonry. The binding strength of mortar is usually disregarded as far as the strength of the wall is concerned. What is brick masonry? Now we will discuss about what is brick masonry and types of brick. It is a very highly durable form of construction. It is constructed by placing a brick in mortar in a such a systematic way to construct a solid structure that withstands applied burdens. There are many types of bricks and mortars which are used in brick masonry work. The bond between two bricks in brick masonry which adheres bricks together. The bond is very important for bonding the bricks together. The joints between the bricks filled with suitable mortar. We should take some precautions while mixing and placing the mortar in brick mortars. It is greatly affected by the quality and durability of brick masonry. That mortar is very important. Brick masonry is a highly durable form of construction which is traditionally used all over the world as well as in India also. It is built by placing bricks in mortar in a systematic manner to construct solid mass that withstands exerted loads. There are several types of bricks and number of mortars which can be used to construct brick masonry. Now we will see the classes of bricks. There are mainly three classes of bricks: first class, second class and third class. Now we will see the first class. First class in bricks, cement of lime mortar is used. The surface and edges of bricks are sharp and the thickness of mortar joints doesn't exceed 10 mm. In second class bricks, the ground molded bricks are used. Bricks are rough and shaped slightly irregular. The thickness of mortar joints is 12 mm. In third class bricks, bricks are not hard rough in surface with disordered shape, used for temporary structures, used in places where rainfall is not heavy. Now we will see the image or diagram of this burned brick masonry work. Types of brick mortars used mainly depend upon material. First is brickwork in mud, which was used in ancient time or old days. Clay is used to filling various joints brick masonry work. Mortar joint thickness is 12 mm. Employed for construction of wall with maximum height of 4 meters. Unmud brick or mud brick is an air dried brick made of mixture of loam, mud, sand and mortar mixed with binding materials such as rice hooks or straw. Brickwork in cement. This type of brick construction is nowadays used mainly. This construction is done by laying bricks in cement mortar instead of masonry clay used in brickwork and or clay. There are three major classes of brickworks in cement which are summarized in the table which we have seen in last page. Quantity of cement, sand or mortar required for brickwork is in 1:2 ratio, 1:1, 1:2, 1:3, 1:4, whatever mentioned as per description or in tender or as per description in the project or project specifications, where it is 1:2 cement and that N is sand, proportion of sand. After adding water to mortar mix, it bulks and reduces the volume by 33% and during the wet condition. In order to calculate the dry volume of cement and sand or brick mortar, we have to add 33% of extra volume to it. Now we will see the types of bond used in brick masonry. First is stretcher bond. we can see the image of this stretcher bond. In stretcher bond, all the bricks are arranged as stretchers on the faces of the wall. We can see the stretchers in the faces of the wall. And the stretcher bond is only suitable for half brick wall construction. In stretcher bond, all the bricks are laid in stretcher courses, but care should be taken to break the vertical joints. We will see that the vertical joints, how the joints are broken. Here is vertical joint, here is vertical joint. Now we will see the header bond. In header bond, all bricks are laid as headers on the faces of the wall. You can see this in this image. Generally, header bond is suitable for one brick wall construction. Now we will see English bond. In English bond, alternate courses of headers and stretchers are used. We can see there. The course, stretchers, headers. We can see this. Headers and stretchers are alternate courses means used. This type of bond is generally most common type of bond, which is suitable for any wall thickness. Different type of wall thickness, this English bond is used. It is considered to be strongest bond. Now we will see the Flemish bond. In Flemish bond, each course comprises of an alternate header and stretcher. Here is stretcher, here is header. We can see this. The alternate headers of each course are centrally supported over the stretchers below it. Every alternate course starts with header and header at the center. Now we will see the measurement. For measurement of brick masonry, generally some rules to be followed as we will discuss here. Brick masonry is measured mainly volume thickness depend upon the thickness. If the thickness is more than single brick, it is measured in cubic meter. And for single bricks, it is measured in square meter. Masonry work are those mainly used in cement and sand, that is fine aggregates. It is does not include the coarse aggregate. Masonry work in such brick masonry is generally measured in volume, as we have seen. And it is if thickness is more than single bricks, 230 mm of 9 inches, it is measured in cubic meter. While for half brick or single brick, it is used in square meters. While measuring the quantities of brick per wastage of materials such as bricks, cement and sand is not taken into measurement, but it is taken for rate analysis work. This is taken care while pricing the different masonry works. Size and mode of measurement. There are traditional brick size, nominal size nominal size 230 mm by 150 mm by 70 mm. That is 9 inches by 4.5 inches by 3 inches. Standard modular bricks, standard size 190 mm by 90 mm by 90 mm. Mode of measurement. As we have seen, the 230 mm thickness wall is measured in cubic meter, while 115 mm thickness wall measured in square meter. Now we will see the partly beam or band for the half brick work. Whenever half brick is constructed, it is partly beams or band are to be constructed at every 1 meter interval. Mainly reinforcement concrete band is used at every 1 meter interval. 115 brick work shall be called as half brick work. It shall be built by laying bricks in stretcher bond. These walls are may be constructed forming cavities of partition walls inside the building. Brick work shall be reinforced with either this following method. With 8 mm diabars, 2 bars at every third layer, and partly beams 115 to 100 mm high with any grade of concrete M15, M20 or any grade of concrete shall be casted. Beam shall be reinforced with 2 numbers of 8 mm dia tor bars and 6 mm dia MS links at 300 mm center to center. Partly beams shall be at every 1 meter interval of height. It is used to strengthen that half brick wall. Points to be observed during supervising the brick masonry work. Ensure the quality of bricks by doing some physical test as well as laboratory test. Make sure that the brick courses are perfectly horizontal. The verticality of a wall should be checked frequently using plumb bomb. Whenever work is stopped at the end of the day, the brick masonry work should be left with the toothed end. Walls with height of more than 1.5 meter should not be allowed in one day. For one day, we have to construct only 1.5 meter height wall. Brick masonry work should be cured continuously for 2 days, and total curing period should be minimum 7 days. Add a face joint to a depth of 12 mm to 20 mm so as to use as key for plastering or pointing. The thickness of mortar joint shell is 10 mm to 12 mm both horizontally and vertically. That's all for today. So please keep watching my channel. Please like, share, comment and subscribe my channel. Thank you.